Oscar.
Afternoon. Morning, evening.
Morning for me, yes.
Morning for you, evening for me.
You're going to be streaming. I started doing a stream for a group called Sleepy Streamers. It's basically to promote narcolepsy.
I saw you post something about that.
Yeah.
And I think I saw you post something about that. I saw the post on Facebook. It must have been about 2 a.m. my time. And so at that point, I thought, that's interesting, and then passed out. I didn't see any of it.
Yeah. To anybody who's... you might want to... You can join the channel. I can... My dog's barking. Shut up, dog!
The only thing I'd say about this team is that obviously you can't give out the password for it.
No. No. I'm not doing that. I'm just saying that yeah.
No.
You have, we have people watching. You are on my stream.
Watching.
Yes.
You can
join the stream and, Oscar, yeah. By the way, this is Oscar Hardwick, legend in the UK. At least I think he is. He's 20 years old,
really?
And he doesn't even have to try. This guy knows he can beat me any day of the week. Like, this guy is probably, I could learn a lot from him, and he's 10 years younger than me.
To be fair, a lot of that's because you have a job and do things. Whereas I don't.
I do things like sleep all the time, yeah. Well, and that's the thing, like, once I can take Xyrem, I'll get my, I think I'll get a lot of my focus back, my reaction speed, because as narcolepsy started going in, I used to be fast, Oscar. I used to be faster, okay?
Right, a minute, my phone's going.
Okay. But watch the stream. Criticize me if you... Oscar and I, mates in series, he's... Now driving in top level series, like he's but becoming a big fish in an even bigger pond.
Yeah, it's one of those things is that you can enter a series, and this is true for anyone in regards to, this is a sim racing thing and not so much a narcolepsy or other thing, but in regards to the sim racing, pretty much anyone can enter a series and be the quickest person there, but when you win that, you tend to be directed to, oh, here's another series you should try, at which point you come 15th, and you're like, oh, all right. That's yeah. Problematic.
I think the last time I won a championship was only a couple of years ago, but it's like... Good days. And then I had to start driving against people who are faster, example. Yeah.
Yeah, that's the thing, is as soon as you do start winning stuff, you'll end up against...
somebody who's off the Formula One or some shit, yeah.
Yeah.
Worse cheating.
Like, whoa.
I'm just kidding.
Well.
Yeah. No. We're getting better at that.
I don't hold it much.
So, Oscar, what do you think? What do you think about sim racing, Oscar? Do you think it helps you drive the real thing? I'm just. The people you're talking to are going to be people who have no idea really what racing is. Oh.
Well,
somebody loves your accent.
I know, I saw.
Thanks Oscar is much, single, England, ladies. He's
ready to very single. It's what happens when you're an engineering student and play video games all the time. It's a natural course of things. Looking at this. Ooh! Wow, daily stages rallycross. You know what? I could win that. I could legitimately win that.
Are you getting, oh yeah, by the way, Dirt Rally, they have a whole leaderboard for this. Every day they have daily stages and they give you rewards for it. And Oscar almost always finishes in the top 5, top 10. You'll see my times and they'll compare, my friend, we'll compare our times. Oscar's like 20 seconds ahead of me.
I'll do the Linden Hill Rallycross because, like, there's been a lot of mixed stuff about the Rallycross stuff coming in. I've spent a long time sort of tweaking the car and getting the upgrades on it, so...
Do you have any frame rate issues?
I think the technique... no.
Huh.
Although, to be fair, that's because my computer's sort of... It shouldn't.
that out.
I understand that there's been, to be fair, there's been a number of issues with the new added stuff as well. Some that has actually affected me. One that's common is since the update, people have been having their controllers come up as disconnected on the game. And of course, first time it happened, in a state of panic, going, oh god, is it not working? But normally, if it disconnects and reconnects, you'd get a recalibration. I didn't get that, and it kept happening. I looked into it, and apparently it's quite a common problem at the moment, so we shall see.
You ever use these perk slots?
And, I shan't.
Sorry, I keep interrupting you.
Perk slots?
For your team, your engineers. Unlocked some of them.
It's one of those things, like, if you've got empty engineer slots, if you're willing to extend the stages as well, because at the moment, looking at yours, you won't be able to afford the way of damage and get it repaired. Oh. If you fill those up, and I think I've got a couple on the three perks and the rest are on two perks at the moment, all five slots filled. And I can write off a car and repair it in about 2 minutes at this stage. So... Do you know what's a good thing to do? I found that the best value for money is go for the last bloke that costs 12,000 credits. Go for the last bloke that's 12,000 because he's better than the first bloke that costs 14,000.
Really?
Yeah.
But another thing to bear in mind. Oscar, I have all this money now.
Yeah, but you don't want to spend it on that really, but because. You buy them, and then there's the perks, and the perks cost money. So,
I didn't know this.
First perk's 20,000 credits, and then it's 40, 60. And... So the last bloke that costs 12, Turbo. He's not very good on Turbo, is he? Have a look at that. You're a vain enemy. Oh, I can't say
No, I still, I can still go for another one. Another guy does 77 at the Turbo. Up to 5.
Yeah.
This is the single player aspect of it, by the way. You build up your team. As you race, you get engineers
one thing
working
I'll say,
with
you. I'll say single player on this is really good. The single player is good.
But I mean, you're working with a car that's inherently, like, it's going to be slower. At first.
Yeah.
It's like in real life.
Now the cars have upgrades and you sort of complete stages and rallies and you get experience to unlock upgrades and it's like weight reduction and power.
Right. Oh, I'm seeing it here.
Saved
I see
up pennies on the game to get. Like, I saved up enough money on the game to get my first of the modern rally cars. Right. So the 2010, yeah, they're 650,000 credits or something. And so I got the Mini, and yesterday the Owners Club stage. Oh, no, it's the weekly actually that's 2010s at the moment. The weekly is the 2010 cars. I thought, yeah, I'll give it a go, and I did it. I wasn't that fast, but I didn't make mistakes. And I ended at like 208th. And I thought, well, what's going on there? And I had a look at the upgrades. And if you complete the upgrade chain for the 2010 cars, you actually gain over 100 horsepower.
Wow.
So I ran it with 100 horsepower less than all the other people. And it's like, oh, that's why it was slow. So there's a lot to be said for having the upgrades on the car. Like, there's a lot of them per stage to be gained. Like, 100 horsepower, that'll be 15, 20 seconds if you don't muck up.
See, I don't want to spend my money on that, but I want to do these daily stages because you have to own the car to do... Anyways, better hurry up and start driving. Yeah, people are like, what the fuck, man?
Do some driving, do something.
Ah! You know what? I'm going to...
Yeah, sir.
I haven't come back to here in a while, so I'm going to do a event. I want to play around with the faster cars. Where should I go? Think of one of the
Germany,
places.
Germany, I think it's Krusigring. Germany, Krusigring, and do it in a Ford RS200.
RS200?
Very good little stage.
You mean the car that was only in production for a couple of years because Group B stages, they were too dangerous to drive? I
not
like
specifically
it.
Specifically because they went through development in... They went through development in 85. And then
I'll
they competed at the end of 85 and in 86. Six whole stages. Oh, okay. Just randomize them then. Just do whichever one
you want. Yeah. Randomize the conditions.
Yeah. Just go full. If you're going to do a number of stages, just random it.
Okay, I'm random it.
In 86, they were, in terms of aspiration, and they were producing a lot of power, and it actually was much better balanced than all of the other cars, including the Peugeot. They actually just had a weight problem.
So that they had fiberglass, though, right?
Well, for a Group B car, and again, with the Group B cars, the weight almost always came from the four-wheel drive system.
Yes.
Because an 80s four-wheel drive system was never intelligent. They were pretty dumb, particularly the Audi one. They won championships simply by having butt-tons of power and a big turbo, because the four-wheel drive was rubbish and it handled like a bus. But they had four-wheel drive and it went fast in a straight line, so they won lots of rallies. Plus, the Audis were quite reliable from memory.
That fire breathing.
The problem with the RS200 is actually it would have them rallies and championships in following years as they shaved the weight down and developed the car. They sort of hit two problems, the first of which was that about a third of the way through 86, they came to a decision that 87 would introduce these Group S cars, where they took away the requirement of 200 production models, which was, I believe, the requirement to be. You could enter a Group B car provided that there were 200 production models of that car made available for general sale. And Group S was going to be, these are prototypes. There's no need to sell a vehicle. There's no need to do any of that. You can do whatever you want and make it as powerful as you want. It was very much an open class. And then there was Rally Portugal and I think Rally Finland of 86. And basically, I think in either spectators or drivers or co-drivers were killed.
No, I know what you're talking about. I think that was Portugal. RS200, when it exploded. I think if that wouldn't happen, Michelle Monaghan might have actually World Rally Championship that year. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. Well, Michel Mouton was runner-up in 83.
Monaghan. What am I thinking, Monaghan? That's a fucking... That's an actor. What? What is wrong with me?
Michel Mouton, I believe, was runner-up in 83.
I thought it was 84. I'm sorry.
In an Audi Quattro. It could be. I don't know.
I don't know. I didn't even get the name right, so, that was a year before I was born.
Yeah.
Yeah. But anyways, yes, go ahead.
It could be 84, because I'm tempted to say it was these when the 037 won.
Yeah. So yes, this thing's a badass.
I believe it's called the RS200 because 200 of them were made. I think.
I have not driven one of these before.
Lots of power, very heavy, very stable, because it's got brilliant weight distribution.
Right. I think this would be, engines in the rear engine, right? Mid-engine, sorry.
Middle.
What view should I do? Should I do the whole steering wheel, hands on it thing, or... I hate driving that way, but it's a...
Whichever suits your screen, really. If you
I want the people to appreciate just how hard this is. Nah, whatever.
We'll go to the dash, and that's the view that I wrote, because,
I'm just doing a shakedown. Getting a feel for the car.
Go. Right 6 over crest, caution braking, turn acute left. Don't
quite
cut.
Good, really. Yeah, I like the RS.
Into turn left 4, 250 through dip.
It's been interesting. I mean, the good thing is that actually, next
turn
month, you'll
right,
go and actually
opens.
Race each other in rallycross cars online.
And
so,
turn right
that
3, don't cut.
This balanced.
Into left 6, long. And turn right 4.
But my wheel is fucking all over the place.
Into turn left 4,
I can feel the rears
crest,
going off
18.
In the rain.
Right 6 dip, left 6.
Yeah, I mean, it's sort of the problem, in the RS200 isn't heavy, realistically. It's about 1,200 kilos, which is a lot, but, 450 horsepower, and it's pretty much entirely coming from turbos.
I think I should shorten the gears a bit.
Generally, the trick with this is shorten the gears to the point where you can do the hairpins in second.
Okay, I was having a problem doing them in seconds.
Take them to about the middle. off the
in
the
rally in rally, for those who don't know, rally is like a 3-day event, like a 2-day event, but the World Rally Championship, it's a day event, goes over hundreds of kilometers. They divide it up into stages, and they're by themselves, they're being timed against everybody else, but they go on all types of surfaces, that badass drivers. So they get to the end of the stage, they have to drive normal speed to the next stage, that stage, go. But preparing for it, they get recon of it, and set up their car a certain way, and that's what we're doing right now. And also, you'll hear that there's a co-driver, and he's reading off like notes to me, note-taking system, how they do it. I just kind of use the, I understand the note system, but sometimes if I can't hear correctly, I'm screwed. I'm trying to tell you how the turns are, way too many turns, you can't memorize it. And co-drivers are, what Oscar and I are doing right now, I'm asking them, how should I set this car up for these weather? It could be raining this stage and then not raining the next, but it will change the dynamic of the car. All right, go ahead, Oscar.
You want me to give you advice on the setup, or?
Yeah.
The wet in this.
It seemed pretty centered. I just needed a better gear, like lower gear. But
soften the rear suspension with clicks and one click off the front damping, and reduce the viscous diff center by a click. And what that'll basically do is it should make the power more evenly distributed in the front and the rear, and should stop any locking under braking through the wheels connecting with the ground in terms of damping and suspension.
Oh yeah. I didn't get to do the Formula Visa Monday.
No, I did some stock car last night, basically because it was a club event that mimicked the format for the league that they're doing soon, the touring cars.
Oh, my game so crashed.
What about that? All of that effort.
I know. Actions taken by Catalyst. Crisis to... Back in a second. Man, of course, like the one time it ever does this stuff. Did DiRT Rally have an update today?
No.
Something's...
Ironically, yesterday there was a new patch to stop the game crashing. It's worked well.
I forgot to turn off all the crap that would cause... I don't know if they can hear me now because I'm not showing anything. Oh no, I'm streaming distant. Nothing. Black screen. I'm starting to back up.
OBS or whatever is just waiting for DiRT Rally to be turned off.
Oh jeez. And we got a girl from Canada.
Ah. Canada. That's like America, but civilized, isn't it?
Ah, shut up. Yeah, you're probably right. I'll be right back. Thing I hate about Nuvigil is like, yeah, it's great, it wakes me up, but shit, I have to drink tons of water, which, you know, normal human beings do.
Yeah.
I appreciate you coming on here.
I can agree with that. Normal people drink water.
Okay, let's do the custom event. Back. Oh, cool, it saved my event.
Yeah.
Concrete has better grip than asphalt. Cobblestone.
But not in the wet.
Oh, you're right, yeah.
Because asphalt is more absorbent than concrete. I believe.
I remember when I was first doing this many years ago, and I was having... there's not a lot of Americans that actually do a lot of sim racing. There has been recently, but for the longest time, I was alone. And they would, like, you know, terms like tarmac and things. Talking about.
All of the Americanisms in regards to racing, it's all NASCAR terminology.
I know, I hate it. I don't use it.
Pit road, pace car. It's like, no. Pit lane, safety car.
You said this is rear suspension up one click, right? And then the front damper's down too.
Down on the rear suspension.
Oh, okay.
A softer rear suspension stops the rears locking.
You know what I hate is when you make a setup and I go to save it, or and I think I'm going to load it, and I actually just saved over my old one, and I'm like, shit. All the time.
I did it a few times with the rallycross cars, and it was like, oh, I just got that set up right, and now I've completely gone over it.
Here we go. Final countdown.
Go. Right 6 over crest. Caution braking, turn acute left, don't cut.
So is this another shakedown or are you going for it?
Into turn left 4.
You can talk through dip. What'd you say? I didn't even hear you. Damn it, I don't have the gears low enough.
Is it a shakedown? Oh no, you're going. Okay. No, it's okay. I can see
turn
it.
Turn hairpin right, don't cut, opens. And turn right 3.
This thing's swimming under braking.
Into left 6
like
long.
It. Oh shit.
And turn right 4. Into turn left 4, 80. Crest 80. Right 6 dip.
Don't cut. But lost it.
Right 6, 80. Caution, jump past junction 100.
The problem with this car having its engine in the middle is when it
caution
goes sideways.
Turn acute right.
All that weight near the back.
Fuck!
100.
Have you crashed?
No, I mean, I guess I just didn't hear him.
I don't need to wait.
Turn hairpin left, don't cut.
I wasn't paying attention.
150 through dip.
80 over crest with into
turn
acute
right.
Right. Oh, that's a miserable corner. The acute right pull is so late.
Into turn right one, ditch outside, narrows. 100 through dip or past junction.
It's a shame you're up in the first second.
100 over crest.
I know.
100. Caution, keep left, into right 5, immediate turn, square right, don't cut. 80.
And a tornado?
Turn hairpin left, 80.
Where?
Turn hairpin left, don't cut.
The
80.
Aircraft.
Turn square right, don't cut.
Yes,
into turn acute left, don't cut. Into turn right 4,
this
four,
is awesome.
Half long.
This thing rotates just how you want it to.
400 past junction.
Really good car, and like, when you get some, get like particularly the weight saving it.
And turn
it,
right one, don't cut.
As well.
Into
if,
turn
there's
right
not
one, don't
many
cut.
In regards to when
and
you get
five,
the upgrades that really compete very well with the 205 in the Group B's. But this is one of the cars that probably can.
Right 6.
It's always
and
nice.
Crest, 500.
500.
Double caution, braking deceptive, turn right 1. Into turn right 3, don't cut,
break down.
Turn keep
right
in, rocks on exit. 100. Crest
100.
Ooh,
deceptive, that's always
down.
A scary thing.
No drivers rating the
turn
turns.
Acute left, don't cut.
One is very severe. Six. This is a knot.
100
over crest to finish.
The corner.
That was a short stage.
It's quite a few, it's like... Six right into six left. You don't even notice. You just hold it in a straight line.
Yeah, but sometimes, like, I've been so off. I'm like, oh, man, if I wouldn't have missed that, I was only 6 seconds off at the end. I must not have it on hard. Let's do a friends comparison here. You might have you driven on this? No. Huh. Oh my god, Oscar. That's a 23-second difference.
To be fair, you did get a 13-second penalty.
That's true. I have a friend called Ham Sandwich Bobo.
Notice, though, that mine only puts me, like, 124th in the world.
Yeah, but you have some crazy cheat. Oh, when you think about the world, do you think about the thousands of people that are playing this?
Yeah. The one to watch, like I say, is I will do that daily event later for the rallies, because...
I'll watch that.
Yeah. I don't suspect that much clicking.
What's the problem? They're still trying... They even said in their update they're still trying to catch the cheaters. It's so sad that you have to cheat as fuck. I mean, come on. Oh, nighttime. Nice.
Well, there's really nothing on the line either with Rally, which is what upset me about it. It's like...
Yeah.
We're not winning anything here, you know? It's just bragging rights. He's cheating for that. Like...
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. 200 past junction.
I have good old night lights on the RS200.
Into left 5, don't cut past junction.
Oh god damn.
100. Crest past junction. Into right 6, over crest past junction.
I didn't see that bump.
80. Turn left 1, don't cut. 80. Turn left 1, don't cut. 80.
There's been one thing that's irritated me watching this, that all of your units are in Old English.
153 dip, and crest past junction. Care jump maybe past junction. 80 past junction.
Although England is an annoying place to live,
right, six,
so we've sort of picked which units we like and just mix
and match. Crest and crest. Caution braking turn right.
I wish that we just had
into
met.
Turn right one, don't cut past junction 80.
Let e-brake. Yeah.
Past junction 80.
I also legitimately left wish six, that we drove on the right hand side of the road.
Right 4, past junction 80.
Okay.
Left 5, 100 past junctions.
Problem is now.
Right 5 over crest.
Everyone's used to driving on the left here.
Care left 3, don't cut past junction.
Right now, for those who know who might not play as much, I'm doing a lot of my driving through my feet.
Rocks on exit.
I'll explain that in a second. Maybe I just got lost. What the hell? Oh fuck! That's what I get for talking.
Press jump maybe 80.
I didn't listen to him. He said turn left. I turned right.
Up junction. Into left 6 long bump and crest. Yeah. Caution braking left 3.
I'm no Martin
right
Brundle.
Six,
that was almost 30. A lovely recovery as well.
Caution right 5. And turn right 4, don't cut.
It's very different. I have a lot of header when
keep
I'm
in,
rocks
on exit. 250 crest.
That was a rock.
And caution crest, immediate left 5, don't cut.
He's a beast! Fucked!
250 down.
Stop talking! The minute I talk.
Turn right 4 through dip, don't cut, narrows. 80 crest. Into right 5. Left 6.
Whoa!
Caution braking, turn square right.
That fuck has just lost his legs.
40 past junction.
I'm not talking anymore.
80. Turn left 1 long, cut. 60. Right 5 long, 100 through dip. Care turn left 1 don't cut, opens. 100. Caution tight chicane right entry, 150.
Are you fucking serious? I have no more lights for. Oh, it's good.
No
more lights!
Left entry, 200.
I can't see! That...
Care turn square right, don't cut. Truck on exit.
Oh, yeah, you mucked up that.
60 crest.
Oh. I'm doing it.
Pass junction.
Not the force, baby.
Right three,
I'm using
it. Cut. 100 through dip, pass junction. Left 5 times 3, don't cut.
The
60.
Out of your way.
Not the most.
I wonder if I recovered the vehicle, it'd give me lights again.
No, it won't.
Right 3 opens long, pass junction. Down. Turn square right, don't cut. 80. Left 5 long, don't cut. 150. Caution, turn right 2, don't cut. Immediate turn left 4, don't cut.
This thing's a monster.
150 past lay-bys. Right 5 continues 100. Into caution, turn left 5, bad camber, keep mid on exit. Past junction, 80, crest. Left 4 over crest, don't cut, 80. Right 6, don't cut, 80. Bump dip. Right 3, half long, don't cut, past junction. Left 6, past junction, don't cut. And dip. Right 5, 6, past junction, 80, crest. Turn left 2, don't cut. 100. Caution braking, turn open hairpin right, don't cut.
You know what?
Turn acute.
That guy. I'm stage.
Five, four, three, two, one, go. 200 past junction. Right 5. Into left 5, don't cut, past junction. 100. Crest past junction. Into right 6 over crest past junction. 80. Turn left 1, don't cut. 80. Turn left 1, don't cut. 80. Left 6 over crest, keep in. 150 through dip. And crest past junction. Care jump maybe past junction. 80 past junction. Right 6. 100. Crest and crest. Caution braking turn right 1, don't cut. Into turn right 1, don't cut. Past junction. 80. Past junction, 80, left 6. Right 4 past junction, 80. Left 5, 100 past junctions. Right 5 over crest. Care left 3, don't cut past junction. Double caution, dip, right 5, immediate hairpin left brown bales, keep in, Brock's on exit. 200. Crest jump maybe 80. Bump junction. Into left 6 long, bump and crest. Caution braking left 3. Right 6, 130. Caution right 5. And turn right 4, don't cut. Into turn square left, don't cut. Keep in, rocks on exit. 250 crest. And caution crest, immediate left 5, don't cut. 250 down. Turn right 4, through dip, don't cut, narrows. 80 crest. Into right 5. Left 6. Caution braking, turn square right, deceptive. 40, past junction.
Understeer. I locked
80.
Up the rears.
Turn
the front.
Left 1 long, cut, 60. Right 5 long, 100 through dip. Care, turn left 1, don't cut, opens, 100. caution, tight chicane, right entry, 150. Caution, tight chicane, left entry, 200. Care, turn square right, don't cut, truck on exit. 60, crest. Pass junction. Right 3, don't cut. 100 through dip, pass junction. Left 5, tightens 3, don't cut, 60. Right 3, opens long, pass junction.
I'm brain farted there, so bad.
Down. Turn square right, don't cut, 80. Left 5, long, don't cut, 150.
In what way did you brain?
I was turning in too early.
Turn
I'm okay
right
though.
Two don't cut. Immediate turn left four don't cut.
Why that?
150 past laybys.
What am I doing?
Right five continues 100. Into caution. Turn left five bad camber. Keep mid on exit. Past junction 80 crest. Left four over crest don't cut 80. Right six don't cut 80.
I'm using left foot braking and it's causing me to almost spin out. Junction. I need to stop doing that.
Left 6 past junction, don't cut.
Yes.
And dip, right 5, 60 past junction, 80 crest. Turn left 2, don't cut. 100. Caution braking, turn open hairpin right, don't cut. Turn acute left, don't cut. 150.
The reason why you're saying crest, don't cut
junction,
is because there's rocks
five,
there.
Into the right 5, over crest. Into caution, left 5, long, braking through gate. Turn right 3, don't cut. And right 5, tightens 4 through dip. Into left 4, don't cut. Opens long, 80.
My first time with this car, but I like it. It's just that I'm not... It's not the car, it's me. I'm not controlling the weight transfer correctly. And I'm, you know, turning in too early
caution
and having to deal with that.
Down. Into acute right, down. Into left 6,
yeah, there is
80.
Quite a lot of weight in it.
Right 6, 80.
Unfortunately, I guess.
Yeah, right 4, rocks on exit.
Yeah, and you find
left
out at the
five,
wrong time.
100 through dip. Caution braking, open hairpin left. Down. Into hairpin right, don't cut, 200.
It's certainly not the heaviest, because the heaviest cars, I think, are actually
left
the rally
cars. Left 5 crest, deceptive, 100 down.
I'll check that, actually.
Caution braking turn, open hairpin right, don't cut, 80.
I'm interested to know which one
crest
is the heaviest.
Crest 80, right 6, through dip, 100. Double caution, keep left at junction, jump maybe. Braking left 3, long pass junction. Don't cut crest,
I'm
keep mid,
driving like
on
a
exit.
Grandma through this part right here because I can't see the left.
100 through dip.
You know the heavy
right
force part.
To finish.
Yeah.
Can't see with the light because my left light went out. Driving flat out, achievement unlocked. Driving flat out into the unknown is about confidence. It showed a car going off the side of the mountain. Or Austin probably go.
Last junction.
Oh wait, no, that's not. I hate that they don't let you use
crest,
your mouse.
Last junction. Into 80.
I found out what the heaviest car is
turn
in the game.
That. Oh wow, I've never watched a replay before. The brake
80.
Lights glow and stuff. Or the brakes glow and stuff. Look at this.
Yeah, it's very pretty in replay.
I didn't realize this.
Care jump maybe past
oh,
junction.
Oh wow.
80
holy
past
crap.
Junction.
I haven't, I've never watched this.
Right 6, 100.
What was the heaviest car?
And crest.
Ford Escort RS Cosworth. So.
Past junction 80, left 6.
Right. That's either cheating or a very impotent bug.
Okay, left 3, don't cut past junction.
Like what they said was, yeah. Remove driver arms from the car with minimize bleeding or whatever, but they said in that update. You catch that?
Yeah. Without causing him to bleed out.
Bump junction.
So
into left 6 long.
I did
bump,
the daily stage, which is the rallycross, right?
Right.
Caution braking left 3.
And
you did the joke.
One of them has to be a joke lap. Yeah, you have to. It's part of a code, the rallycross rules. And so I did it. And it was decent, because it's just the daily stage and not the owner's club, I put my setup on it, so I struggled a little with the car. So I, over the 4 laps, it was,
I was only 3 seconds, behind you. Wait a minute, that was when I was
that run that you've just done.
No, okay, nah, never mind.
So I did it in 2 minutes 5:05 over these 4 laps, which is reasonable. I mean, there are people that have gone 10 seconds quicker, and I believe that. The guy who's currently leading, mind I've done a 2 minute 5.5, the person who currently has the fastest time on the daily stage, 9 seconds.
No way.
Yes, that's right. Laps and one joke lap in 9 seconds.
I'm fucking sad, man. Mm. Oh, the joke.
You
okay.
Actually have to be breaking the sound sphere 2 or 3 times to manage that.
Mm-hmm. I hate it.
The owner's club I can do because I have the Fiat. I have the Fiat 131 Abarth. Don't really know why I have it, but I do.
You know what I didn't know? But I realized when I was looking at a development video, these are just like the real life stages, like almost turn for turn.
Yes. The German ones are a bit strange because they're all named different to the stage that it's based on.
Ah, yeah. Is it like a shorter version of that
German
stage?
Stages are from... Well, they're actually 2 connected pieces. Basically, the sections that you've got equate to a little over 50% of the actual stage. And the actual stage it's on is another one of those sort of like modern classics. In regards to World Rally stages, and it's a Panzerplatte. So all of the rocks that line the road, they're actually designed to stop tanks because it's a World War II tank testing facility.
Right. Yeah.
Edelsteins. So that's what everyone keeps crashing into on them. But you've basically got about 22 to 25 kilometers off the stage that they've modeled. And the stage itself is 44 kilometers long. In the real world. So you've got a section of it. Sweet Lamb, the Welsh stage, is incredibly accurate.
Yeah. I was looking at that. I think that's the video, the one I was looking at.
Yeah. That's good. Greek stages? Probably. I don't know. They have been to Greece in the past and Cyprus and... It's very sort of like Cyprian, even a bit Kenyan when they did the Kenyan rally, quite similar to those stages. Monaco, 80, yeah, I'm pretty sure that they've got quite a lot of the top, particularly the top parts when you get to the snow of the colder terrain. Right.
Caution turn right 1. Into keep right over crest.
Still, we've got 2 more like rally environments to come. Which is Sweden and Finland. And hope that
crest.
They at least do
and
some of the Toya for Finland.
Dip, don't cut. Care right 4 half long.
Just any of on employer would
turn
be.
Square left, don't cut. left 6.
Sweden's anyone guess? Anyone's guess because their stages aren't particularly consistent, given that they're sort of like dug out of snow.
Yeah.
But we will get proper snow stages. I'm interested to see. I'm interested to see how they do the snow stages and how they
level 6
the grip
80
on them.
Through dip.
Yeah.
It's quite a peculiar thing with the studded tires.
Definitely.
60. You've got lots of
crest. Caution turn right one.
The grippiest stages.
Keep right crest.
Longitudinal grip. Lots of longitudinal grip. So when you're accelerating, when the wheels are straight, they produce a lot of grip. But when you're going sideways, you're not actually using the spikes for traction. They're just digging in. So at that point, like, it's sliding. So there's no grip when you're going sideways. It's only when you're pointing it forward. So you have to throw it in at the corner to the apex and straighten it up to get the drive off.
Crazy.
Turn hairpin left, don't
cut. Like, there's a real art to getting the car
and left. Using the snowbanks to their advantage.
100 through dip.
That's dangerous as well.
Keep left over crest past junction 80.
Well, too little and you're using time, too much and it sets you in, you get stuck.
Just square left, don't cut, to keep in, rocks on exit.
And like, you don't see any much that happens every year in rally, but something that does happen every year in rally is people get stuck in the snowbanks in Sweden.
Keep left over crest. Right 5 continues for 100. Caution, keep left, into turn right 1, don't cut. 60 through dip. Into right 5 long, don't cut. Into turn hairpin left, don't cut.
Crazy, this thing was made in the
80s. Opens 100. Crest 300 through.
Yeah, I mean, I was watching a 1983 British Rallycross event 80. On YouTube the other day. And it was the first Rallycross event, right or one of the first Rallycross events, where the Group B cars were turning up.
Left 6, 80, dip.
And in the heats, they had a penalty for being four-wheel drive.
Crest, past
in
junction.
The heats, they had a 9-second penalty. Crest. So, to qualify into the finals, they had to finish 9 seconds up the road from second.
Gate on exit.
Interesting.
100. Right 6, 80.
I believe it was as a measure into the back of the grid for the finals.
Turn left
without
one,
actually, you know, just adjusting it to say we're putting it back as we built it.
I'm paying attention to you, but I'm not paying attention to the turn. He said turn left one. I went in at third gear.
I was watching it, and like a car in the UK, like in 81, 82, that won most of the time was the Porsche 911. And so I was watching this, and you had Shankler and some four-wheel drive Escort.
Turn square left, 80
but he was up against these rear-wheel drive Porsches, but one of these Porsches was producing 650 horsepower.
Left 4 long, 80.
Rear-wheel driven.
Double caution crest, turn left 6, don't cut, ditch outside. 100.
Really?
Turn right 1, don't cut, keep in, rocks on exit. Up.
Not directly
right
to hand.
Continues for 100.
I love watching when Porsche does a road rally. Oh my god, it's amazing.
Turn hairpin right, don't cut.
Yeah.
Into left 5 long. And turn open hairpin left, don't cut. Keep right over crest, 100 through dip and past junction. Right 6 over crest, caution braking, turn acute left. Don't cut. Into turn left 4, 250 through dip. Turn hairpin right, don't cut, opens. And turn right 3, don't cut. Into left 6 long. And turn right 4. Into turn left 4, 80. Crest 80. Right 6 dip, left 6, right 6 80, caution jump past junction 100, past junction, caution braking, turn acute right.
You'll enjoy it because it's got everyone's favourite commentator commentating on it.
Turn hairpin left, don't cut, 150 through dip.
No.
Turn right 1. Into turn right 1, ditch outside, narrows. 100 through dip and past junction. 100 over crest. 100. caution, keep left, into right 5, immediate turn, square right, don't cut. 80. Turn hairpin left.
Great.
80. Turn hairpin left, don't cut. 80.
Turn square right, don't cut. My tires are screaming right now.
Into turn acute left, don't cut.
You're gonna have to think about
into
the rest of the
rally. Four half long. 400 past junction.
Here's the option to repair, which is mid-stage now.
And turn right one, don't cut. Into turn right one, don't cut.
I knew that was a mistake of me. You gotta be thinking about it. You gotta be wondering when you're like hitting the top of fifth gear. You're like, I should probably lift off at some
and
point.
And left five continues for 80.
I understeered right. It's a turn, deep right turn. And it's understeered. I thought I had enough time to brake.
Nope. Six. And
I noticed they fixed that with some of the patches. The braking.
Double caution, braking deceptive, turn right one. Into turn right three, don't cut, down. Keep in, rocks on exit. 100. Crest, 100 down. Turn acute left, don't cut. ...100 over crest to finish.
Carson. Eastman. Do it.
It is good, isn't it?
I love what you put up the other day, by the way, was people saying, like, I don't particularly like Rallycross, and it's like, well, making a video about it.
Yeah, it's like, oh, I don't like Rally. Good, keep it to yourself.
Right.
Like
you're blaming the developers for putting Rallycross in a rally game? Oh my god.
I don't like mushrooms. Don't put up videos slating them.
Because if there's mushrooms in this forest, I cannot. Understeering it when I'm going downhill.
350 over small crests. Caution, turn left 2 over crest, don't cut. Into turn square left. 400. Keep right. And left 6 long through dip. Caution, right 5 long. Immediate turn, square left, don't cut. And turn square left, don't cut. 80. Past junction.
They turn left and it. Right, come on.
300. Care, keep left over small crest. Turn left 4. And turn acute right, don't cut. Turn square left, don't cut. Into turn hairpin right, don't cut. Into turn square right, tightens. Into square left. Into turn left 5, opens 100 through dip. Pass junction. 100. Caution, keep right over crest. Immediate turn square left. Into turn square left. 100 crest.
Making too early, too late.
Turn hairpin right, don't cut. 100.
Frequent issue when there aren't brake markers and things such as that.
Crest, past junction 100. Past junctions. Care jump maybe. Left 6. And right 5 through dip.
But you sort of need quite a good perception of distance for it all, because you've got all the distance markers in the casements.
Turn right 4. And turn left 4, don't cut, 80. Double caution right 5, immediate turn left 3 over bump deceptive. And turn open hip and left, don't cut. 200.
Ooh. You said don't cut.
Crest 80. Caution turn right 4. Immediate turn acute right, don't cut. 100. Keep left over crest, 100. To finish.
Car slightly on, but I like that because I needed to be a bit more predictable. Map over, but downhill, especially, I'm one, I'm braking too. Two, I find myself overshooting the just understeer, you know what I mean? Like locking up the fronts.
Yeah,
change it back to the brake different, or a brake bias.
Yes.
Oh wait, I can't even. On a nighttime stage, no. Oh, they have that summer sale going on, don't they? For race room?
Race room, yeah.
I mean, anything out there that's fresh to get?
Oh, no, I can't.
Are you driving at the moment? I'm sorry.
No, not at the moment.
Braking, turn square left, don't cut, through gate, 200. Caution, tight chicane, left entry, 150. Caution, tight chicane, right entry, 150. Caution, turn open, hairpin right, don't cut, down, rocks on exit, 130 through dip.
Any good entry?
Left 5. And to turn right 2, keep in, bad camber. 130, past junction. Turn square left down, through gate, 80. Right 6. And left 6, 170. Caution, turn left 4, don't cut. 100 up.
I'm to hesitate on those tight stages a bit too much.
150, caution turn right 4, don't cut. Crest, 250 through dip. Caution braking, turn square right, don't cut. Rocks inside and on exit. Into turn left 3, don't cut. Bank on exit. Left 6, 150. Double caution, left 6, immediate turn square right, don't cut. 100, crest, right 6, bump over junction, 100, jump maybe, 100, caution braking, hairpin right, tight, round bales, left 6, right 6, 60 dip, left 5, past junction, care right 4, don't cut. Into care, left 5, rocks outside, past junction. Right 6, long, 80. Left 5, half long. Right 6, past junction. 80, past junction. Caution, turn left 1, don't cut. And turn left 1 over crest, don't cut. 300. Left 6, 200 through dip. Keep mid over, big jump, 200. Caution, right 5 over crest, jump maybe, deceptive. Braking, turn square right, don't cut. Care, rocks on exit, 80. Turn right 1, don't cut. Care, rocks on exit. 100 past junction, 80 crest, left 6 past junction, 150, right 5 don't cut past junction, left 5 past junction, 100 to finish.
Hey, Princess and Peach. That's awesome. Thank you. Rough stage, man. Night stages. Gotta have some confidence.
Yeah, they're not straightforward.
Well, I thought it'd be easy, but you know, I guess you just don't realize how much you rely on looking ahead.
True.
There's a viewer on here, Princess Imp.
Yes.
Okay. Going into the last stage. 3 seconds off from first. I don't know, 7. Can't count.
You're gonna want to not muck it up then, anyway.
Yeah, it's in the morning, it's rain. Stretch it out a bit. Caffeine in me.
Bad for you, that is.
Not bad for you. It's just it's a highly addictive substance. Of course, I'm not gonna say it's bad, but I will appreciate the day that I won't. I don't know as much, man. Pump to myself with caffeine. To do races, yeah. You know, when you have that sort of crash, that caffeine crash or whatever. All right. This is Sleepy Streamers is brought to you by Nubagil. Thing that helps Brandon Warren complete rallies. Nubagil, get yours today.
That would be listening to pace notes from there.
And list all the side effects. Makes you feel like shit. But at least you're awake. Glorious. Awareness. The day. Okay, here we go.
This will be good.
I keep saying it. I'm like, here we go. And I keep having to get up and do something. Come on, Brandon, come on. Yeah.
I blame the dogs.
Not this time, I don't have to watch them as much. Text messaging me. Bang. All right, maybe I just wanted electronic. Now, I'm not gonna push it, dude. There's no way I can make up 7 seconds in that short of time. Unless he fucks up. Like, never happens. I don't even know the guy's name. Probably from Finland. Look at that, I got a cracked windshield.
Overstein's probably my favorite stage of the German stages.
Yeah, this is the one I'm on.
Okay.
I have to take it easy.
Five, four,
let's do it!
It's tricky, three, the first couple of seconds, so.
One, go.
Ease yourself.
Left 6, 80 through dip. Right 6, into left 4, into right 2, down.
Oh my god.
Jump
the one with all the camber.
Left 6,
holy shit.
Through dip. 200.
I'm fighting this wheel.
Hairpin left. Don't cut. 130. Right 6 half long. 250.
I know.
You know what I should have over the summer? I live in the garage.
Huh?
Into hairpin right.
Sorry, I just saw you muck up the hairpin.
Right,
whilst I'm at home in the summer, I'm in the garage, and so far, the whole time, I've shared the same sort of like 5 feet of space on my computer with this huge
right
spider.
Six, into immediate hairpin left, up. Hairpin right.
Oh my god, this stage is so beautiful six, in the rain.
Right 4 times, 3 don't cut.
Dirt, right, two, dirt up, rally is an incredibly bumps. Game. Oh, you're up in sector 1 and you went off.
And left 3 past junction through gate.
I don't know how.
Right 5 long past junction. Crest. Left 5. And right 5 through dip. 40. Dip 100. Caution braking, turn acute right. Don't cut. Into turn square left long. 100. Turn right 1. Don't cut. 100 past junction, 60, caution left 5 bump, don't cut, be brave,
60 cut, be brave.
Right 6 past junctions, left 3 long, don't cut, 60 keep right, left 6, don't cut, 80 crest, caution right 3 don't cut, keep in rocks outside, 100 through dip, past junction, turn right 5 cut, 60, left 6 continues 150, crest, 80 past laybys, caution turn right 2 don't cut, immediate left 1 don't cut, 170, right 5 long don't cut, into turn left 1 dip, don't cut, 40 past junction, 80, left 4 long, and right 6 times 3 past junction, opens 100,
I cut in too much. That's my problem. Cutting in too much.
60 crest.
I have to, and I have to immediately start flipping my throttle and adjust for that. Correct.
200. Caution, tight chicane left entry. 150. Caution, tight chicane right entry. 150. Caution, turn open hairpin right, don't cut, down, rocks on exit. 130 through dip. Left 5. And to turn right 2, keep in, bad camber. 130 past junction. turn square left down through gate 80.
I knew that turn would get me. The bad camber turn. I recovered though, quite well.
Right 6. And left 6, 170.
Ooh, yeah, it did.
Push and turn left 4, don't cut.
When he said bad camber, my mind immediately went fuck.
Pressed. 150. Push and turn right 4, don't cut. Pressed.
The worst ones are like when it goes 5 left into immediate right.
Turn square right.
Unfortunately, that means you shift it, at which
exit.
Point you need to be in first to prepare.
3, don't cut. Bank on exit. Left 6, 150. Double caution, left 6, immediate turn, square right, don't cut. 100. Crest, right 6, bump over
shift
junction.
Gears too much.
100. Jump maybe, 100. Caution, braking, hairpin right, tight, round bales. Left 6. Right 6. 60 dip. Left 5, past junction. Care, right 4, don't cut. Into care, left 5, rocks outside, past
junction.
Come
on, okay. That lost it.
Right 6, long, 80. Left 5, half long. Right 6, past junction. 80, past junction. Caution, turn left 1, don't cut. And turn left 1 over crest, don't cut. 300. Left 6, 200 through dip. Keep mid over big jump, 200. Caution right 5 over crest, jump maybe descended. Breaking turn square right, don't
Brandon,
cut.
Brandon, what were you doing? What were you thinking? God. What were you thinking? Come on.
Turn right one, don't cut. Care rocks on exit.
Need to learn more, sensei.
100 past junction.
It's a tricky corner, that 5 right.
80 crest. Left 6 past
junction.
I thought
I had it too. 150. And then I just
right
lost my
grip. Don't cut past junction.
Obviously.
Yeah, I mean, it's a braking
right
zone even
junction.
In the dry.
100 to finish.
Around there, but.
I'm cautious at the turns I don't need to be cautious at. And then I go too hard at the turns I go too hard at. Or that I need to be cautious at.
Yeah, in the wet, I'd almost shift a force through that one. And you're like lifting in fifths. Like, it's probably not going to
I was like, well, it's not going to end well. Oh, man. And I ended up losing a place
to
some
second, the rep.
Italian.
Yeah.
Donut. Oh, wait a minute. Hey. Yeah, second thought. I have it on professional level. I should be beating him. That was fun, though. That was a thank you for that challenge.
Can you name any good Italian rally drivers?
Can I name any good Italian rally drivers? GG Golly. GG!
Yeah.
It's so sad. It's so sad he never recovered from that, breaking his leg. I never heard from him after that.
He's done bits of rallying, a round of the world rallycross last season.
He had such a huge fan base, man. People love that guy.
He's about it for Italy, though.
Right, I'm trying to think of anybody else that I know. No. Yeah.
I can't think of anyone else.
Frenchman. I missed a couple of rounds of the World Rally Championship, and I missed the ones where Sebastian Ogier didn't win, and like Hyundai got their first one. Stuff. I was like, my friend over to United States, Finland, watch Rally Finland.
Really?
Yeah.
That's dedication.
I should have gone with him. I just didn't have, the money at the time. He's gone to like the rally school that like Ken Block has and stuff like that. Nice. Yeah. He really, like, I at one point he bought a front-wheel drive Volkswagen Rabbit. It was the 80s. It was a rally car ready to go, and he was buying tires for it and everything. You know, the $130 for a tire sort of thing. And
yeah,
he just didn't have all the resources. It's one of those ones where you turn up to the rally, you don't trailer it or anything. And you know, of course, it was breaking down at certain. I don't think he ever got to do a rally in it. He kind of realized just how much it really cost.
A lot.
Rally.
Yeah, loads of money. And
oh, you said a lot. Yeah.
Most of it will break. Yeah.
Have to do like practicing.
Yeah, well, I was gonna do a race room one this evening, but it looked like that might be cancelled. I might not race room one this evening. Who knows? I'll see what happens there.
Oscar, you can't be yawning on me, man. This shit's addictive.
I'm not allowed to be the tired one on this stream, am I?
No. You can't be tired.
Technically speaking.
Nah, but seriously, you're not allowed.
No, never.
You hear about Jensen Button?
Yeah, that was a bit harsh, I thought.
Yeah, but they said it wasn't gassing. I don't know why they said it was is Daily Mail type of stuff. I knew I shouldn't have trusted the whole thing. But I'm like, my God, it was a... I think on Reddit they were talking about Jensen Button's actually a secret agent for Formula One. That's why we have we had the Korean and the Indian Grand Prix. And as soon as those Grand Prix were done, like a more conservative government or something came in, mission accomplished or something.
In a not shocking turn of events, in Finland at the moment, where your friend might still be, might have come home, straight after the Finnish World Rally Championship event, they have the Lahti Rally, which is a historic rally. And two names taking part, who are first and second. First is Jari Matti Latvala, second is Mikko Hirvonen.
Ah, Mikko!
Yeah, worth pointing out, he is second in a two-wheel drive Ford Escort Mark II.
Oh,
and he is ahead of the person who is second in the four-wheel drive Group B class.
Oh, that's gotta be a little bit embarrassing.
And Jari Matti Latvala's winning because he's an Audi Quattro, so...
Ah, yeah.
No, basically cheating.
Yeah. Cheat mode on. There's the talking to. I guess I gotta finish my last stage on a front wheel drive 1960s car. I hate front wheel drive. But yeah, dude, that Mikko, I remember watching him in 2006, that's when I started watching, and that's when he really came into his own. And some people argued that, like, he really wasn't that great, or he was only shining for a while, but I'm like, I think he had talent, he just, something got in his head or something, you know, he just got to a point where he just kind of hit a, you know, what happens to a lot of drivers. Drivers plateau for the longest time, and then they take a huge step up, and then they plateau for the longest time.
Five.
It's never incremental,
yeah,
right?
Three, two.
What you've got to remember is during the years when Mikko Hirvonen had a competitive car, he was against both.
Like,
he had what?
In the years where he had a competitive car, he was racing against Loeb.
Right.
Into left 5, 60, right. Keep and right over crest.
Nobody beat Loeb. All of the years, Loeb was in it, he won.
Even when people are like, oh yeah, well, that was the year they didn't have all the manufacturers in and stuff, I'm like, he was still kicking their ass. Like, Petter Solberg probably wouldn't have got that 2003 championship they didn't ask him to, Sebastian to, that let the final rally, they asked him to take it easy and get a stitch from the Structures Championship. I did not know that.
Into left four.
But he could have won and got the Drivers' Championship that year, too.
Yeah.
Left four, into left four.
I'm just happy that I got to see two legends during their prime, Valentino Rossi and Sebastian Haney. And Mike Schumacher.
Into hairpin left.
Although, to be fair, you could argue that Valentino Rossi is still in his prime.
I know. Isn't that amazing? I love it.
I love
the idea that a 36-year-old guy who's full of injuries and everything is still doing it.
Right three, long keep in.
Attention, Brandon.
Left two,
attention,
long Brandon. Dip, pressed. Into right five. Into right two, late. Into turn left two.
There's too much of a gap between second and third gear. Right. I need to change that.
Left five tight. Into right six.
What's the driving a gravel when you have like.
To right six, 60.
No horsepower.
Right one. Into turn left one past junction.
Yeah.
And left four. Right 660, keep right over jump 100, right 6 over jump.
So they're only adding two right more five. Countries after this?
Left 6.
Two more right rallies after this?
In regards to the continued right development down. Of the early access game, so heading towards version 1.0,
right
there will be a further two rally environments and one right more rally press. Cross environment added, along with. Left. 12 more cars, I think.
Nice. That's enough.
It's 15 more for the Rally Cross pack, and then they've released three with that. So I count it as 12 more cars, of which I know what three of them are.
Into left five.
You know if they're doing random like surface changes.
Left five, you're on top of 80.
Like there might be a different bump on that road at a different point.
Into crest. Right
no,
four.
I suspect that the surfaces will remain as they are.
What I do like about this game, though, is the change of surface and how you can really notice it.
Into left four long.
Yeah. But yeah, there's 12 more cars to them. We know what three of them. And we don't know what nine of them are.
Crest.
Although
right two.
You can speculate your heart's content.
Into left six. And right
so,
three,
at the end of
crest,
this
jump.
Month,
80.
We're getting the player versus the Rallycross release.
Right.
For the online.
Right five
so we can
jump.
Crash into each other in real time.
And left five long to finish.
And also another Rallycross car, which is going to be Solberg's DS3 World Rallycross car. Two other cars have been confirmed, as much as remember when they accidentally leaked the patch a while ago?
Yes, yes.
And then hastily covered it up and patched it back?
Right.
Well, in that leak, there were 7 cars, and when they officially released the patch, there were only 5 in the release. So we got, what was it, the 037, the Manta, the Seat, the Peugeot, and the Opel Kadett in that. But in the leaked builds, there were 7 cars, the other two being an Alpine A110 to go with the 60s cars, so that we had some rear-wheel drive from the 60s. And also a Renault 5 Turbo to go in with the rear-wheel drive Group B car.
I was waiting for the Renault 5 Turbo, yeah.
So we know, yeah. So we know that there's a DS3, an A110, and a 5 Turbo coming. There's sort of...
You know the Toyota Celica's coming.
Not... I don't know, they've not announced it, and there's not any Toyota license in there at the moment, so... you can make sort of like reasonable assumptions as to what might not, based on what's already there.
Right.
Uh, So I suspect we will see a Ford RS 200 either Rallycross Cup or Pikes Peak car before the end of development. The fact that they're bringing in the Citroen DS3 Rallycross car doesn't mean that they'll bring it in for the modern cars, but there are other modern cars coming. And one of those will almost certainly be either a 206 WRC or a 208 R5. Maybe both. Because there's obviously a Peugeot license that they've got, because they've got two Peugeots.
Right. I think they'll bring in...
But the difference with...
Go ahead.
Oh, go on.
Apollo.
There you go, that's right.
No, I mean Polo. They'll bring in the Volkswagen. Moderns.
Potentially.
But that's right, but we also got to think about,
potentially.
Like, WRC, the official game or whatever, might have locked up Toyota's license, I don't know. I hate it when that happens. Well, and Sebastian loves games.
That's another thing, is like, that's the thing with the DS3, and the DS3 for Rallycross, because the permission comes from Petter Solberg. That is not a license with Citroen. It is a license with Petter Solberg for his car. And I'm tempted to say that the Volkswagen ones are actually the Vulcan dealership team. So I'm tempted to say that's a team license as opposed to a manufacturer license. Because actually, when you open up the game... Yes.
Oh. Yeah. Trying to decide between the... I've... In the 70s championship now. I'm trying to decide between the Ford Escort Mark II and the Stratos. I love them both. I know that I think last month they had their Ford sort of events already, right?
Yeah, I'd still go with the Escort though.
Yeah, you're right.
That Stratos is very difficult to make go quickly. It's such a short wheelbase, and the engine is so very much in the back.
And heavy.
So it's quite difficult to drive. I'll go with the Escort. But no, when you open up DiRT, you know you've got the opening screen, the black screen with its like credits and the licensing on it.
Right.
If you look at that, there are only four things there.
Right.
And two of them are Ford. The other one is World Rallycross, other one is Opel. But presently, they have four licenses. The other stuff, so if basically anything that's not a Ford, that's not a World Rallycross car, and that's not an Opel, has been licensed separately. Peugeot, I suspect, is a license that will go on to that when more Peugeots are included. Because at the moment, you've got the 206 Maxi, the, what is it, the 205, the, basic, the kit car, Peugeot, the 208 for World Rallycross just got added, although obviously there's a World Rallycross license, but there's also two Peugeots in the headline pack. So, I suspect there is a Peugeot license in the way in there somewhere, because there's a few too many Peugeots for it to just be cars from teams.
Right.
And particularly with the most of those Peugeots being historic, I would say probably some sort of Peugeot license. Now, I don't know if that license will be for the modern 208. So I don't want to say will a modern 208 in the modern class. I would say that it's very likely you'll get like a 206 WRC from 2001, 2002.
I want to see that. Instead, Marcus Grönholm and...
That's a likely addition. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's
remember the 307?
Yes.
That car was interesting. I mean, I don't think it ever got full like factory support. I'm not sure. I think in 2005, yeah, I got a full factory support. And then they just kind of backed off of it. And I remember, like, Manfred Stoll had to run it independently in 2006. It looked nice, but... And Henning Solberg drove one, too. But it just kind of looked awkward at the same time.
Yeah, it's fast, but it broke.
Yeah, yeah.
Was its problem. Like, typically speaking, I think in 05, Grönholm drove it. And it'd lead the first three stages, and then all the cylinders would fall out the bottom of the block. was sort of how their rallies went. Great driver, in every sense of the word, really. It's like, again, there's a lot of sensible assumptions that you made about the cars coming. There's lots of people going, oh, I'd really like, not happening.
Right.
Certainly not the immediate future. Because, like, everyone at the moment is basically waiting for the Porsche EA contracts to expire.
God.
Which is due to do this year.
RUF.
At which point, we're just hoping that it's not going to be specific to anyone. You know, I don't really get why they require such large amounts of money for the licensing of these cars from the manufacturers. Because for the manufacturers, putting a good representation of their vehicle into a game is basically free advertising.
Yeah. Exactly. Like,
so, why not just throw stuff? And, like, there are companies that are particularly stingy about it or patriotic about it. Ferrari are a fucking nightmare.
Yeah,
I mean,
they don't want to show the car like all messed up.
Don't give it to anyone, and then they, because Kunos is Italian, then you can have all of them, crash them into shit. We don't care because you're Italian. It's wonderful. So,
it's
all a bit sketchy on that front. Other cars to expect, like, say, the RS200 in either a rally cross or a hill climb capacity.
Right, 580 down, left 6 over crest.
Hopefully, they introduce like a 2 Peugeot 206. They'll feel obliged to introduce a 2002 to 2005 Impreza.
Well, I want to see an Impreza.
Right,
that from that era.
Crowd pleasing, I'm sure.
Right, 6 long over crest.
I mean, if you had
left
the
660. Left 660.
McRae.
Right 6
Impreza
60.
And
left 6 crest.
Burns Impreza in the same
right
game.
Three long down.
Right.
You know, you're ticking a lot of boxes at that point.
Into the caution,
or a Solberg Impreza.
To finish.
Yeah.
There's. And again, Subaru's a tricky one because there isn't any official livery on the Subaru, which must mean it's a manufacturer one, because if it's a team one, you'd have a team livery on it.
Right.
Lancia, obviously, been very friendly, although I'm pretty sure we've just about run out of Lancias to put in the game.
Yeah.
So, there's a shit ton of Lancias. Although, there's no reason why they couldn't like the EV1 or EV2 as a hill climb car. No one would be opposed to that. So there's the potential for them to do that with Lancia still. I think.
5, 4.
If they spoke
three,
to Mazda nicely
two,
and got a BRX7.
Go. Left 6, 80.
That would be pretty nice.
Right 580 down, bomb dip.
And that's kind of plausible as well, isn't
left
it?
Left 6 over crest, 60 down.
Yeah, I've never really seen a game do
Porsche,
feature
right
hill
five,
climbs as prominently
down,
as this.
Right 5 don't cut, it's care.
Another thing that they could
long,
is,
turn left 3 long.
If they introduce, like I said, like a 2000 to
2000
Peugeot,
right
2000 Impreza, they could introduce a 2000 Seat, because the Seat Cordoba was a WRC entry in 99 and 2000.
Was.
Obviously, they've got the Ibiza kit car. So,
six,
they could put a Cordoba WRC in, because there's Seats in it.
Right 660. Left 6 crest. Right 3 long down.
I see no reason why they can't make a mini Countryman
into
rally cross either.
Don't cut.
I remember in DiRT 1 where they had the.
That would be a nice thing to do.
Super 2000 cars. I like those. Like the Honda.
Yeah, I'm semi-expecting seeing a Fiat Punto, a Bath S2000 in the 2010s, the moderns.
I'd like to see one of the Hondas, or just, you know,
well,
something
the
different.
The fact they've called that 2010s,
yeah.
The fact they've called that 2010s almost suggests it might end up with the 2000s and S2000.
Right.
Separately. And they might, like I say, I don't know in the way of 10s what cars they could put in there in regards to licensing issues and what they do and don't have access to. Yeah, I'm convinced we'll see more Peugeots. I'm convinced we'll see more Fords. Potentially more Seat as well. Beyond that, they've either covered all bases, like with Lancia, or they're team cars, and it's a separate kind of thing.
Left six, eight,
so we can't have any more engines.
What's your favourite era of the WRC? Tights Group B.
Honestly?
Yeah. Left six over crest.
Mine's not
down.
Group B.
Caution right five.
I understand. And
right
I do
five,
love the cars.
Into caution left four, half long. Into turn left three, long.
The thing with them was is that they were sort of like
into
all group
right
force,
five,
not much else,
60,
for the most part.
Right six, long over crest.
Right, in terms of technically impressive B
left
cars,
six,
you've
six,
sort
six,
of got the Delta
six,
S4,
six,
the 6R4, were both very right impressive
six,
vehicles 60, in terms of the tech and the aero that they used.
Right,
whereas you've got things like
down.
Audi, Peugeot, Ford, and they basically just stuck
five,
big turbos on it and wings that
didn't
really do much.
I'd have to say mid-90s, the WRC era cars. Group A cars.
Group A was very good. Group A was good for a number of reasons, in as much as because of the tight limitations on the cars and having them so close to road cars.
Right.
You actually had lots of different people winning and lots of different manufacturers winning.
I've downloaded tons of like review videos and I love watching that.
Like you sort of had Lancia for a couple of years, Mitsubishi turned up and won like three in a row. Then Toyota won one, followed by Colin McRae winning one, and then Toyota winning another couple.
Right.
Then Peugeot turned up as it sort of moved towards the more modern WRC and they started winning.
Yeah.
Then you had like intermittent wins from Subaru and other manufacturers in between. Then you had Citroen coming after that with Loeb.
And you would have different types of cars winning, yeah. By the end of the rally, you know, I remember the year Richard Burns won 2001, yeah. And like he just didn't, like you thought he was written him off halfway through the.
I mean, I absolutely love more Group A cars. I think it's such a diverse category of rally cars that you can expand on.
Yeah, exactly.
One thing they should do. They've got the Ford Sierra Cosworth RS 500 in its rear-wheel drive form.
Yeah.
Make the Group A four-wheel drive. Add it in.
Yes.
Wouldn't hurt anyone. Evo 2 or Evo 3. An Evo 2 or Evo 3 Mitsubishi, whilst unlikely, would be fantastic.
Right.
Any of the Celicas, they were all wonderful.
Celicas?
I think we can agree on that.
It's a Celica, man.
Yeah. Celica. No, it's a Celica, and you're incorrect. I'm technically like, England as a country, we're friendlier with Han, so
I technically
on this front
have a friend who is almost Japanese, and my nephew is almost Japanese, and that's close.
Do they speak in an American accent?
yeah. Shut up. Okay, whatever.
honestly, my favorite era of rallying is right now.
Are you serious? Really?
Joking, that's not dead serious. Cars at the moment are the fastest they have ever been.
True.
This is the first time since basically the 70s, because they didn't have the radio communication with the drivers, that there hasn't been radio communication, and so the drivers are forced to push on every stage. So you got the fastest cars in a situation where in which the drivers have to go as quickly as they can.
Right.
We've had a number of years in a row, new engineering teams and new manufacturers entering the sport. There are other manufacturers coming. Toyota are re-entering the sport.
Yes.
In 2017, the cars are getting wider, lower, more aero, and 80 more horsepower.
I'm excited for that.
3, 2, 1.
I mean, and people talk about the worst years being the ones with
six,
Loeb 1, but...
I just think
WRC needed to restructure itself, you know? I like that they're accessible online now. In just, you know, common sense.
Caution right 5, 60 down. Right 5.
WRC Plus is the best service offered by a racing team in terms of price and actually what to get for it.
Right 5, you get a lot. I love it. And but you know what I had to do before? It went, since I was American, you know, I couldn't get certain footage or anything. Locked. I'd had to.
Right 660.
Go a different route.
The footage for years was just bad on the WRC. Like it was. But
caution left 5, don't cut.
It's been improving dramatically. WRC Plus is a big step in the right direction. Left 4, and as much as people 19, tend not to like to think about it, actually this the paid subscription to specific racing series is very much right something 4. That will catch on.
And I think it's fair. Like some people are like, oh, I don't want to pay for this paid apps. Like, dude, that's pretty fair to ask me. No.
Into left 6. Press back.
I'm forgetting my new rear-wheel drive car. 60.
Hairpin left around 3. 100. Up.
So, like, present day's my favourite. Because
hairpin right.
It is more spectacular, it is more high beast.
Right,
it's safer for the drivers and skaters. And maybe that's not an excitement point, but I for one don't want to see drivers that have a personality and that I like getting killed crashing into trees.
Right,
right. No, it's like, very dangerous.
Like, there's plenty danger as it is. We don't need to take away bits of roll cage and
right.
Make that magnesium right, so they catch 16. Fire. No need for it. Like,
hairpin right,
there isn't. It's still dangerous. People
right.
get killed in motorsport every year. Why tempt fate by making it more dangerous?
I think what they needed for the
these faster cars as well.
They needed a little bit of diversity.
Their safety, where they
narrows.
Sorry, I talked over you, I didn't realise it.
Left 4 long, opens and tightens over jump.
It's okay. Like, they're in a stage at the moment,
it's a right 4 long.
The cars, three, where they can go 3 miles an hour backwards into
it's
the
It's a left
train,
6, like 80 over jump.
And like, left that's five, a really good 60. Safety. So they've got to this stage of safety from Group B in 86.
Left 6.
And obviously that's a while ago. But if you think
left
about it, like 30 years isn't that long for
right.
this left many loops to make.
Jump.
And so now that they're at this point that the cars are super safe, they feel comfortable to make them faster and to make them more aggressive. I think that they've had a really good natural progression from when they moved to Group A to now. And there's been, like,
right five,
I don't know why people really branded recent years of World Rally to be so bad, with, like, you know, only a couple, like, World Rally has always had this ebb and flow of manufacturer identity, right?
Right.
There have been points where there were six manufacturers or seven manufacturers. There have been points where there were, like, one and a bunch of privateer
entries. Left 6, 100.
It's continued to exist. It will continue to exist.
Right.
We're actually currently on one of those upward slopes. We went from Ford and Citroën, and now we've got Ford, Citroën, Volkswagen and Hyundai, all of whom, the right driver, are capable of winning rallies.
Right,
we're getting Toyota, that's 5. Most of these teams enter 3 cars, at which point you've got 15 factory-backed entries. Although Ford
yes.
is a factory-backed, you know, M Sport's basically the same. I mean,
yeah.
M Sport run Bentleys all around the world and
yeah.
Ford Rallycross and rally cars. Like, it's close enough.
It is, that's what I think.
Like, they're
yeah.
not going away.
No.
So, you effectively would have the equivalent of 5 factory-backed efforts starting next year, or the year after, dependent on what Toyota choose to do.
I'm glad we're on that upturn, yeah. You think and then once you get a more factory, you're going to have more independent. IRC was really good for a while.
What? It's merged now, IRC. With
yeah.
the ERC.
Yeah.
It's going quite well. There's lots of people in it. Like, one thing that annoys me the most is when people start moaning about modern WRC, going, oh, well, it isn't Group B. And it's like, Group B stopped for a number of good reasons.
Yeah, yeah.
The cars aren't loud enough.
Yeah, because we don't live 30 years ago and we can make them more efficient now.
Right.
But it's the same bunch of old sods think the racing they were a kid was the best.
Yeah.
Which is just rubbish. They look at it from a this subjective standpoint of I really like how Audi Quattros look or something. It's
yeah.
like
I can appreciate you. I'm totally with
2004 again. What you do? You wish that there was one car at the front that won everything?
Yeah.
No overtaking.
I realize people are saying that. I think they just want that sound or something. And I'm like, those cars could barely pass each other. And yeah, I don't think you want to go back to that racing. I think you just want to. Because I remember 2005, I don't think people were like excited for the V8s, their aero changes, and all this kind of stuff. You know, they wanted it at that point. I'm like, now you're trying to say you want to go back? Yeah, right.
Well, not only that, but they want to go back to a time in F1 where when people mocked you for being motorsports sunset. Fans saying, isn't that where they go around and overtake each other? Like, from 98 through to about 2006, I would say that is a very accurate representation of Formula One.
That's what my dad would tell me. He's like, that's why I don't watch it. No passing.
And people will go, oh, but wasn't it so much better when a pass was an occasion? Like, I don't view it as a positive that it was an occasion because it happened once every three races. You know?
Right.
Like, I think there are small changes to be made to modern F1 to make it really good. And everyone else wants to, like, just rip every bit of it away and go back to old cars.
Yeah.
Well, that's a backwards mentality to have.
Yeah, and they're not going to do that.
One thing I always say about the modern F1 cars is, with the fuel saving, make fuel tank size an option. Let them do the maths to decide what fuel tank size is the most competitive over a race distance. So if it's 120 litres, they push it all the way, fine. If it's 90 litres and they push less, it's fine. But let it be an engineering decision, not a governing body decision. Take away DRS and replace it with the F-duct. The F-duct isn't an instant on and off. It comes in and it comes out. So there has to be conscious effort from the driver to properly use it. And also, it's less effective than DRS. So you gain some speed, but not as much. So passes wouldn't be happening halfway down the straight. They would happen at the end where people want them to. So you got fuel tank, effort. And then like things like the manual clutch start. So non-mapped clutch starts.
Yeah.
Very good idea. That will spice things up. And then like on top of that, maybe with the sort of like wider tyres and a little less aero or something, like they're being for 2017. Like, wider and lower, more mechanical grip, as it were. And, like, Pirelli get a lot of shit as well for F1 these days. Like, Pirelli were hired in make bad tyres.
Right. They were, yeah.
You know, they were employed by Formula 1 to make tyres, and they are still employed by Formula 1 to make bad tyres. So getting rid of Pirelli and bringing in Michelin, but having Formula One ask a different tyre manufacturer to make bad tyres still produces bad tyres, you know?
Right. And that's what got to me. I'm like, really? Because, but, I mean, I thought they were going to ask for tyre manufacturers, bring back the tyre manufacturers. You know, I love that analysis that would come in. Oh, this, you know, this circuit might suit the Bridgestones over the Michelin's, all that kind of stuff. I always like hearing about that. I thought it'd be great for tire manufacturers, yeah, but to bring it in and like control tires, I'm like, hey. Don't ruin your relationship. I do love the modern F1 cars. I love the technology to go, and that's going to be used in our cars and other things. You know, someday very soon. It has to be relevant. So I've never really done rallycross before. Joker lap is a lap that you have to do. Why do they have a Joker lap anyway?
As a strategic device. Adding strategy to rallycross. In as much as, like, if you were behind a slower car because of a bad start,
and they didn't take the Joker. You would take the Joker for some clean air.
Right. Oh, and, I got you.
In the World Rallycross, the Joker lap is a longer lap that you must do once per race. But in Global Rallycross in the States, the Joker lap is a shorter lap that you can only do once per race.
I get you. Jump start, you must take an extra Joker lap. Oh, these things are 600 horsepower, I forget.
Well, the ones in this game are 600 horsepower, not over. Although I wonder if that's a World Rallycross regulation restriction or something. Regulatory restriction would be the best way to...